Hi, this is Ms. Barnacle again. In this module, we're going to talk about prime factorization. And when we talk about prime factorization, a couple of things you need to know first. First, you have two different types of numbers. You have composite and you have prime. If you notice up on the screen, it says composite numbers are numbers that have more than two factors, and it doesn't have to be that many more. Four is a composite number because one times four gives you four, as well as two times two gives you four. If you can find at least just one other number besides one that goes into there, it is composite. So it says a few of those. Prime numbers are numbers that only have two factors, like the number one, the number three, three times one, seven, 11, 13, and 37 are few. There is one exception though. The only even number that is prime is the digit two. Two is the only number because two times one is the only thing that is going to give you two. Now, the easiest way to break these composite numbers down is to know the prime factorization, which means factor trees. So we're going to work on a couple of these up on the board, and the two that we're going to work on are 950 and 504. I'm going to move us to the board now, and we're going to talk about those. Okay, the number 950 in the previous module, we talked about examples of numbers that could help us, rules that could help us figure out what divides into 950. And we said one of the rules says if it ends in zero, then 10 will divide into that number. So let's try that and say 10 times 95, because all you had to do from one of the earlier modules when we talked about multiplying with shortcuts, when you multiply with zeros at the end, you do one times that number and then just add however many zeros you need to. So 10 times 95 will give me the 950. And then you have to ask yourself, well, okay, does anything else divide into this? Well, one of the rules said if the number ends in 5 or 0, then 5 will divide into it. Well, you should know that this ends in a 0, so therefore 5 will divide into 10. 5 divides into 10 two times, so that would be 5 times 2 gives me 10. Now 5 and 2 are both prime numbers, so I have to stop there. Once you reach a prime number, you stop. Okay, then I go over here to 95. Again, the rule says if 5 and 0 goes into it, then 5 will divide into the number. So 5 divides into 95 19 times. Okay, now we already know that 5 is a prime number, but on our list you have to look at 19 and say, okay, well, anything multiply together to give me 19? And the answer is no. So I am done. I have divided as low as I can go. Once you have all the prime numbers listed, then you have completed your prime factorization. And there is a way that you write this. You start with the smallest number, which would be the 2, times. We have 1, 2 5s, and you learned in a previous module that when you do multiplication, when you multiply a number to itself, that would be squared to the second power. So we write that little 2 exponent, and then the number 19. So the prime factorization for 950 would be 2 times 5 to the second power times 19. And that's as low as he will break down. Okay, let's do 504. 504 is an easy number. We should know that 2 divides into it automatically because the last digit is even. So 2 divides in there however many times. If you need to do this, you can do this. Scratch paper. 2 divides into 5 2 times, which makes 4. That leaves me 1. Bring this down. Remember, does McDonald's serve cheeseburgers? And 2 divides into 10 5 times, which makes 10. Bring the last digit down, 4. 2 divides into 4 2 times, and there's nothing left. So 2 times 252 is how many times that goes in there. Okay, and then we just keep going, all right? 2 is a prime number, so we're going to stop there. I'm going to go ahead and circle it. That way I don't forget it when I come to write my prime factorization later. All right, 2 goes into 52. Well, let's try 2 again. So 2 divides in there. Get your little scratch paper out, 252. 2 divides into 2 one time. Bring down the 5 because there was nothing left over. 2 divides into 5 two times, which makes 4. Leaves 1. Bring down the last 2. And 2 divides into 12 six times. So 2 times 126, excuse me, makes 252. And then I'm just going to keep doing this. Now, you don't have to just divide by 2. You could choose other numbers if you want to. Like 6 plus 2 is 8, plus 1 makes 9. Well, we learned a rule that said if the digits, when you add them, if their sum is divisible by 3, you can divide by 3. Or if their sum is divisible by 9, you can divide by 9. Well, 6 plus 2 is 8, plus 1 is 9, so 9 should go in there. So that would be 9 times... scratch paper. 9 divides into 12 one time. That leaves me 3. Bring down the 6. 9 divides into 36 four times. So that'd be 14. We're almost finished. 9 does break down one more time, and that would be 3 times 3. Oh, there's some prime numbers. So I'm going to circle those. And then 14 breaks down, and that gives me 2 times 7. Those are prime numbers, so I circle those. Now, this has a lot of prime numbers, so let's write them out. I see how many 2s? 1, 2, 3. I see 3 2s, so that would be 2 to the third power times. I see 1, 2 3s. That would be 3 to the second power times 7. There's only one of those. So the prime factorization for 504 would be 2 to the third power times 3 to the second power times 7. So that's all that we have for this lesson. And I hope that you come back and join us. Remember to print out all of the notes. That way you can use them to help you when you answer the quizzes at the end of the modules.